Oh, am I standing in your way? Oh, sorry.
Well, that last video ended quite poorly, I must say.
Yes, I haven't got all day. Now, if you'll excuse me.
So we'll try again. This time I have Lydia and Vilya with me in case I get bushwhacked again. I'm prepared this time. Uh-oh. I spun it around. Revenge! Revenge! That's what I'm after, is revenge. Is that them? Are those the ones that gave me the kibosh?
Shoot him! As fast as
No match at all. Hey, laughing boy, no match at all. If I recall correctly, in the last video, I was just trying to stay out of arm's reach from these guys while my Dremora played patty cake with them. Yeah, I was near some iron deposits, so I thought, what the heck? Let's see if my pickaxe animation works still in the game. This playthrough's gone on pretty long. I mean, not hours long. I haven't put that much hours into this playthrough. But I have put, like, plenty of Rigmor. Rigmor, she is a mod by herself, if I must say so myself. And, so it felt like this playthrough's been a long one. I want to say, though, that by now I've played as much without Rigmor than I've played with Rigmor installed. In this playthrough,
I'm on my way to Solitude to join the Legion. A united empire is better for everyone.
But the passage of time is hard to tell, really. Because of the leveling up in the game is not linear. You can't say something like, oh, that was just 20 levels ago. Or that was just 5 levels ago. You can't do that with Skyrim because each level seems to take twice as long to get as the last level did. It's progressive? Like, the time between level 3 and 4 is basically 15 minutes of real time. The time between level 1 and level 2 is maybe 2 minutes of real time. But the time between 31 and 32 could take quite a while in the game for it to happen. Quite a while of real time. Now, when some players will say something like, ew, my character was level 100. What they're saying is they went into cheat codes and just manually set all their skills to 100 and set their level to 100. They did their point buying, or points, they used their point stealing convention for building their character. I'm all for point buying, just not point stealing. My hope was, while making this video, I would pick a nice quiet time where there's no car races outside, no dogs barking. I was hoping. But I have to keep pausing my recording because of drag races, and I got my rice cooker making pasta. So I've got my egg timer ticking away. I don't know if you can hear the ticker in the background. Set it for 30 minutes. Was it 2 cups of noodles with 1.5 cups of water? And from the gurgling that's coming out of the steam, I can tell that I didn't rinse out all of the starch. So you probably hear some gurgling going on in the background too. I had to throw away one of my egg timers yesterday because
look over there.
It'll be going tick 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 and then it just stops. I was like, hey, you still got 20 minutes left on this timer and you just stopped ticking? But I've had the timer in a storage box for like 20 years. So I'm guessing the glue, not the glue, but the clock oil or whatever timers use probably turned into a thick lacquer, a thick varnish. It was overpowering the gears inside the timer. So that's the medical excuse that it had. It was free. It came with a cooking utensil set that I ordered. You know, operators are standing by as seen on TV, one of those cooking show things. 2 a.m., I'm starving. I see a cooking, an amazing contraption that cooks amazing foods, and I'm hungry, so I order it with my credit card. And then I never use it because I'm not a cook. But I'll keep the little stupid things that come with those pots and pans.
I'm learning fast, don't you think so too?
Like the timers and the veggie chopper and the cheese grater and the other thing. The pots and pans I usually end up putting out by the dumpster. Never opened, you know, still in the box. Some bum immediately grabs it. There's so many bums now where I live. It's not even funny now. Yeah, the middle class is disappearing. The lower class is expanding like crazy. And the poor class is just astronomical right now. No wonder people are on the internet trying to become internet famous. It's the only way to become middle class now. To be an internet superstar.
Did you hear that noise?
Yeah, if you're a girl with cleavage,
don't you think so?
You can make some good money on the internet, on YouTube, just talking about anything as long as you got your cleavage showing. You will have subscribers, guaranteed. Now, fat guys with neck beards have a hard time making money on the internet, so they have to have co-stars sitting next to them with cleavage. Then all of a sudden, they get subscribers for some reason.
What's the situation?
Stormcloaks.
Good to see you, my friend. I knew you'd make a proper legionary.
Okay, so the plan here.
I'm glad you'll be with me.
My plan is still to.
I don't like the looks of this place.
Go pick up Serana.
Talking about the Stormcloaks.
I want Serana to come with us when we do this quest. But I thought, you know what? Instead of leaving these guys high and dry, out here.
No matter. We have the element of surprise.
I'll at least follow them up to the front door. Make sure they're all encased in the tomb.
Follow me.
And then I'll go spring Serana free and bring her back with us.
A Nordic ruin. What say you? Should we investigate?
I realize some of you may know men on the other side, but remember this. They are the enemy now and will not hesitate to end your lives either. General Tullius is counting on us to bring back the Jagged Crown, and that's exactly what we're going to do. Let's show these rebels what real soldiers look like.
Now, I'm guessing the bandits are always dead, because the Stormcloaks were here first, and they probably killed the bandits. Or maybe I killed the bandits earlier in the playthrough. I just happened to be in the neighborhood and I killed them, but I hadn't discovered this place yet, so it wasn't me that killed them. Because I know if I did kill them, they would still be here waiting for me. And they only clear away when the quest is done. The Jagged Crown quest.
Well done. They never knew what hit them. But don't underestimate the Stormcloaks. Many are Legion veterans. They may be traitors, but they know how to fight. We had the advantage of surprise this time, but don't expect it to last. Let's move out.
I like how they're all after you, after you. They've all got their cue orders. He thought he was next. Nope. This guy ninja'd in front of him. Okay. So that part of the quest is done. So now we can go find Serana. And haul her behind over here. And finish this quest up. I'm in the mood to see vampires attacking my fair citizens in my fair villages. And that, I'm guessing that happens more often if Serana is let loose. Because there have been very, 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 very few vampire attacks in my cities. And I haven't had one single traveler show up in any of my cities. The guy with the black robes on, the hooded black robes. He's just called a traveler, and he's walking towards you, and then he's like, oh, surprise, I'm a vampire. And he always dies because he tends to be low powered. Anyway. I totally snuck up on that, whatever it is, that wraith, ice wraith.
Good. I wish I could use a bow that way.
I think Sky Test might be doing something with the ice wraiths. Making them unawares that you're just running through here. There, if there's three of them, they always attack you. If there's two of them, they might actually run away from you, I'm guessing. If there's one of them, they might not attack at all. I'm guessing. I'll have to check in the records to see if it really is Sky Test that touches them, or if it's the add-on Sky Test that I'm using. It's called Harder Predators? No, what was it called? It's called Sky Test Harder Creatures?
What was that?
It makes all the creatures in the game harder to kill or fight or...
The one down?
Playtest does all the animals. I mean, not Playtest. Sky Test does the animals, and Sky Test Harder Creatures does the monsters. Like the, the trolls. And the other things. I guess the last time we were here was when I was with Rigmor. So I was curious who all was here. Oh, I totally missed. I missed again? God, I'm so lousy at this. I'm lousy at crossbows, I've discovered. I don't know where the thing goes. I can barely see my cross arrow. My cross beams, or whatever they call it. I want to shoot that person, but I'm guessing. I don't know if I hit. I'm guessing I hit Lydia instead of this guy. I'm totally missing.
Stop it.
I thought maybe I could hit him in the face with my crossbow. I couldn't even do that. I need to get out of here so I can think. I keep clipping on things in here. Where'd he go? Where is he?
Come on. We are
I guess Vilya freeze-dried him. Okay. Now, I came in here with Rigmor one time, inside the tavern, so I was curious what would be happening in here after ripping out that mod. And it acted as though I had not even been in here yet. So this is the default
is someone there?
Interior of this tavern. So that's the tavern, the innkeeper, whatever his name is. Vilya tried to resurrect him, I guess. I was trying to loot him. She was trying to reanimate him. What's his name? Beryl something? Anyway. So that works. I was expecting to see leftovers from when Rigmor had some NPCs down here, but it acts like this whole cell never happened. So I'm guessing Rigmor overrode the interior settings of this cell with a replacement one. Without touch, you know, it makes like an alias of this room, makes some changes to it without changing the existing room. So when you do rip out Rigmor, and you do come into this room, Skyrim uses the original room instead of looking for that old alias that it had before. It's kind of clever how it all works. So Rigmor is sort of one of those mods where you're allowed to rip it out in the middle of a playthrough if you want to. And it won't totally kibosh your game. Meanwhile, we're still on the quest to not save, but procure Serana. I thought I'd go pay a visit to the Vigilance of Stendar, the Hall of Vigilance, or whatever it's called. And I was shocked that I hadn't discovered it yet. I thought I'd been here. Might as well take a look-see. In one playthrough, there were dead Vigilants laying around in here. And I didn't know if that was a default thing, or if a mod had added those. Because normally when I come in here, I just see dead vampires. I don't see any Vigilants. There's usually one laying on this table, but I didn't see him this time. In my previous playthrough... Oh! It's time to get my food out of the rice cooker. I'll be right back. Okay, I have returned victorious. Perfect. I set the timer for 30 minutes. And the noodles are perfect. I just have to write down these settings I'm using, so I'll remember the next time I make my food with the rice cooker. It all comes down to barometric pressure. Are you at sea level? You know, are you in a box with a fox? You know, that kind of thing. Because otherwise, rice cookers are kind of finicky as far as consistency. You know, sometimes food comes out perfect from the machine, and sometimes you're like, what happened? Where did my experiments go wrong? We are here. Dim Hollow Crypt? Is that what it's called? I'm just gonna race through here because I'm metagaming. I just wanna get Serana. I'm not interested in roleplay at all. I'm only here to kill the things. So I'm not interested in everyone's little side stories, backstories, you know. Like, who are these vampires? What were they talking about? What issues do they have with other prey, I guess. You know, the vampires always have their own little clans. Have you noticed they're very family-oriented, and they don't like other families. That's just the way vampires are. And I'm looting the vampires because they usually have soul gems or emeralds, flawless things. They like shiny objects. Oh, here's the vigilant guy. Tolan, I don't think that's such a good idea. Is the voice of Isram the same as the voice for Three Dog from Fallout 3? I don't know if he's in... I'm guessing he's in Fallout 4 also. I don't know. I don't know, the guy that does Fox in Fallout 3 does my Dramora.
That I'm not bad.
I saw another teaser for Fallout 76. So apparently the game starts with you just walking out of the vault. It's Reclamation Day. So everyone got to leave the vault, and you're the last one to wake up and leave the vault, so you don't know what all has happened the night before. I mean, you have like a hangover, so maybe you don't remember what happened the night before, because there's like lots of celebrations, lots of partying. And now everyone's gotten up early and left the vault, and you're still in bed waking up. Takes place in West Virginia. And the sky looks too pretty, if you ask me. I like Fallout 3. Yeah, Fallout 3 had the DC Wasteland.
Now I'm gonna get
West Virginia doesn't seem to have that that wasteland look to it.
Shall we continue?
So, I'll look forward to another teaser film from the game. I'm curious what direction the art director took to get the tone and the theme for the new game. And hopefully they'll release another Skyrim 2 video next week, showing a little bit of the game. All I want to know is, does your character talk or not? Uh-oh. What was that? Yeah, I got naked stuff going on, so I have to black it out.
Over here!
Shall I describe what's happening? We're fighting vampires. Just imagine that we're fighting vampires. I mean, Velia's healing me while I'm getting my ass kicked.
See that? I'm not a complete milk drinker anymore, now am I?
My Jamora is having sex with a vampire, though. So we're kind of like waiting for that to finish. Meanwhile, I'll just... One of those death hounds showed up.
Did you hear something?
Okay, the vampire is now running around. She's naked. She's running around. She's turning invisible. Me and the Dremora are chasing her down, but she's invisible. It's hard to tell where the heck she is. We lose track of where she went to, and the minute we see her, she instantly turns invisible again. Let's see, did he kill her? Nope, she got away! She's buck naked, you know? Where's she now? I keep looking for her little chameleon effect that she does when you look through her, because you can see through her. She gives... Oh, there she is. Nope, she just turned invisible again, but I still see her hiding. Hiding at the top of the stairs. Get up there. Get it. Oh, she was staying just in... Oh, finally. Yeah, she was staying just a foot in front of us, and my Dremora didn't know that. And then Velia shoots a big old fireball at it and kills it, and then my Dremora turns around to chop off Vilya's head, and he totally expired. You know, his time was up, so my Dremora disappeared right before he tried chopping off Vilya's head. Anyway. What was I saying? Oh yeah, I'm just metagaming here. I kind of know where everything is. I know all the treasure chest things. All the booby traps. I'm thinking, should I trigger them just to get that 3 gold in the chest down the hall, or should I just keep on going? There's a room that has three or four different garage doors that you open, and each one leads to a different chamber, and I'm thinking, ah, should I even bother with that? I'm just here to get Serana. Serana is the actual victory item at the end of the quest. Once you have Serana, you don't have to get anything else, unless you're into Ariel's bow and Ariel's armor. Ariel's boot, Ariel's little helmet thing. I don't remember if there was a knife or a sword that went with Ariel's. I like that. I like how I put my weapon down, my Dremora puts his weapon down, everything's, we're all friends again. I keep picking up everything I see. So now I have to eat stuff to lose weight. It's common practice in Skyrim.
I owe to Stendar, stronger than any.
See, that's a scripted death. I'm not a fan of scripted deaths. Never will be. The minute you make line of sight with these guys, the guy just drops dead. How'd you guys get here before me? I think Vilya just warped down here. Anyway, let's get Serana, shall we? We shall. I'm gonna try not to loot anything else, just do the little puzzle thing.
Yes? Yes? Yes?
I was curious what she would say about this place.
It's strange to think that ancient Nords used to live here.
Shall we continue?
Well, she's right about that. With my last ENB, the flames here were more purplish, and now they're more bluish with this other ENB that I'm using. Kind of different, kind of cool looking. First of you.
Where is... Who sent you here? I think it is, actually. Why would someone who isn't like me come all the way down here? Vampire, yes. That's complicated. And I'm not totally sure if I can trust you. But if you want to know the whole story, help me get back to my family's home. I was going to say the same thing to you. My family used to live on an island to the west of Solitude. I would guess they still do.
Okay.
By the way, my name is Serana.
I like how the next question out of my mouth is, is that an Elder Scroll? Something like that. I had to make sure she had a face light because I can't stand talking to people without face lights. And I couldn't remember which brightness I use in this with this ENB, and I'm thinking I still use the darkest one in the game. Oh, that's good enough. Yeah, she doesn't need a super bright one.
Shouldn't we keep moving? I really want to get back home.
Is that an Elder Scroll?
Aren't we there yet? Yes, it is. And it's mine. Nothing can destroy an Elder Scroll. Worry more about protecting your hide and let me worry about my things.
So we leave it at that for now. We're not old friends. We're just, what do they call it? She's just an encounter so far. And, I don't think I'll tell Vilya about her. Vilya still wants me to take her to fix the donkey tail thing. And
did you hear that noise? Wonder what you are. Come on, show me how brave you are.
We are a good team.
Don't you think so? Didn't I tell you I was good?
Because I think the longer I don't do Vilya's Elder Gleam quest, or whatever that's called, then the longer I prolong her from bugging me about getting married to her. Because when you do both of her main quests, after that she just constantly wants to get married to you. And you just have to keep reminding her how she's just like a sister to you, and then she leaves you alone for a little bit. Until you do something nice, and then she's like, oh, he wants to marry me after all. And you're like, no, no, no. That's not it at all. Now, I've heard rumors. Heard rumors that if you're married already and you get married to Vilya, all hell breaks loose. So I still need to remind myself to go on the YouTube and look for a video of, you know, Vilya finds out you're already married when you show up at her wedding or something. You show up at her wedding already married. I'm curious what happens. I haven't tried it. I'm afraid it might break my whole relationship thing with the NPC ladies. In my last playthrough, I did have divorce installed, so I can totally divorce people on the fly and get married to somebody else, but that started to add emotional baggage to my game that I wasn't planning on. It's not all companions are treated equally in Skyrim. Some don't like to get divorced, ever. So my future ex-wives, they're causing all kinds of problems in the game. I guess the trigger is just me pulling this lever. I could have sworn stuff triggered whether I pulled the lever or not. Where's the combat music? Okay, you can barely hear it. Okay, where's this person at? Someone's shooting arrows in my head.
We are key. Don't you think so?
Yeah, when Vilya doesn't need anyone anymore, when she reanimates somebody and then she doesn't need them anymore, they just dissolve instantly. But Serana, Serana will reanimate somebody, and then that person is just, they're with you for a while.
Something's not right.
You might as well have a fifth wheel with you in the game.
This won't end well for you. Who's there? You knew I was something.
Don't you think so?
Yeah, so I'm just kind of walking around real quick. I totally forgot there was a wall in this place. So I'm just minding my own business, looting Draugrs, Death Lords and stuff, and I hear this chant going on. That's weird. Serana counts as a living thing. Wow. My aura isn't all that great. I only have one shout. Or I only have one word for the aura whisper shout. So I'm not smart enough to know if some living things are not really living. I think the second word of the shout allows you to detect
everything all right here?
Vampires.
Do you need something?
Because they won't show up as living beings. They just don't even show up at all.
Yes?
I was waiting for Serana to say something. Normally she says something here at the steps before we leave the place. And I don't remember if she said it already or... I can't remember what she says, but I know the game will act funny if you leave outside before she says it.